Over the past 4 years, I've been working on projects with large companies. Since ClearRx, I've been working on projects with large companies like Johnson & Johnson and still with Target and, of course, with Medline on projects ranging from increasing the success rate of glucometer testing to reducing the number one hospital-acquired infection to isolation precautions throughout hospitals, all of which have really given me the opportunity to collaborate and to continue learning and to try and continue to make impact in the healthcare arena through design. With Medline, the overarching question that Sue and team came to me was with how can we really support the people who care for us most? And here's my first example of that, and that is our wound care packaging. It's one of the most confusing situations facing many facing healthcare providers. It's a growing problem for nurses, for patients, and for families. Here was the dilemma. Even while research was developing a host of efficacious wound care products, newly formulated and specifically medicated to tackle the most discouraging wounds, the very number of products became confusing. As you can see, the packaging often doesn't help. This is the box that the nurses were getting. There is either no information on the package or a plethora of information, an overload, and it's confusing, and which many times means nothing at all to the nurse. So it was obvious to me that whoever had designed these really hadn't bothered to put themselves in the place of the ultimate user of these packaging products. We also took a look at the inner pouches, because this was very important, because we learned through our advisory board meetings that a lot of times the packaging would, the boxes would sit in a storage closet somewhere, and you would only get that inner envelope. So you had to be able to understand the information on that inner pouch because the outer box was left in a closet. So we met with our advisory board, and they gave us so much insight into this world, because I really had to immerse myself into this new world, which I think is also a good thing to do, because I'm looking at it with fresh eyes. And the first thing and the biggest thing we learned was that the bedside nurse receives only these inner pouches, which of course seldom contains all the instructions listed on the outer pouch. So we thought, why shouldn't the outer pouch explain the product that's used? And it became very clear to us that a properly designed inner pouch could be our great leap forward. And it's really a shame, because Medline invests so much time and talent in producing such advanced dressings that we felt the packaging should really do the job in describing its contents and explaining its use. So we thought, why not make every package a 2-minute course in advanced wound care? So if you take a side-by-side comparison of the Medline packages before, and here's what we came up with afterward. I'll start by just going through all the things for one particular brand, which is Silvasorb. We really tried to design it so that we could call it a 2-minute course in advanced wound care. You can see that the design really does help reduce confusion. The first thing that we did was put a picture of the product on the box. And because we did that, nurses are able to quickly identify what the product is inside without having to rummage through it, open up a thing which might end up in the trash, which does end up in the trash if it's the wrong product. Caring for your wounds, having people care for their wounds at home, was also a very important piece to this puzzle, so we wanted to make sure that we incorporated that in the design, which I'm going to show you as well. And because, of course, we learn that the boxes usually end up in the storage closet, we go to the inner pouch, and everything that's on the outer box ends up on the inner box, on the inner pouch now. So you have the picture of the product on the inner pouch, and then you open it up, and you're left with step-by-step instructions on how to apply the wound care dressing. It's really, we're trying to make it as easy as possible for people to use so that they really can't make a mistake, and that the bedside nurse can give these instructions to the patients, caregivers, families when they get home, so they can apply the wound dressing properly. You'll also see a sticker on the side of the packaging where you can list initial date and time, the time that you put the dressing on the wound, and then you can leave it on top of the wound so that when the next nurse goes in, you see exactly what dressing is in there and when it was applied, so that you won't have it on for too long, because change frequency is very important. This is also a godsend to the families who want to know how long they had left the dressings on. When Dia Kent, who was mentioned earlier today, first saw the wound care packaging at the launch of it during the WOCN, she immediately wanted to test these dressings to make sure that indeed it did work. And we're very grateful for that, because the results have been very positive. And Michael Gray is going to be speaking about it later today. He'll be going into greater detail. But just to sum it up really quickly, 62 nurses received the old packaging to apply to a wound model. And of those 62 nurses, zero performed a dressing change correctly. When 77 nurses applied the new packaging to a wound model, 68 applied it correctly. That's 88% increase with this new packaging, which really helps explain the instructions on how to use it. So I think that these numbers are really explain how much bedside nurses desperately are looking for just-in-time education and information right at the moment of application, especially in this one particular situation. Now I'm going to move to another example, which is catheter-associated urinary tract infections. And that was the next project that we worked on. And we've finished it up now, and it was really an excellent example of collaboration and working together to get a tray that is really superior than what we had originally started with.